As a visitor, I found it easy to feel overwhelmed by what you could and should be doing when you come to Singapore. In this video, I'm going to share with you some of the things that you can do in Singapore that are unique to this city. Number one is to eat at a hawker center. Hawker centers represent the melting pot of cultures of Singapore, including Chinese, Malay, Indian, and even Western food. You can find a great fish and chips at a hawker center. Some of my favorite local hawker dishes, though, include chicken rice, satay, and laksa. The food is really affordable. Meals typically cost around $3 to $20 per person, though some dishes, such as chili crab, cost over $50 per person. Many hawker centers specialize in a certain type of cuisine, such as Malay or Indian, or a certain meal of the day, such as lunch or dinner. There are over 100 hawker centers in the city, and some of my favorites I usually recommend to tourists include Old Airport Road, Maxwell, La Posat, and East Coast Lagoon. If you're visiting a hawker center, remember to bring a packet of tissues with you. This is useful for reserving a table and for cleaning up after yourself. Also, make sure that you clear your tray when you're finished. Speaking of food, make sure that you have something to eat at Changi Airport or when you're entering or leaving Singapore. Now, it might sound crazy to hear that going to an airport to get food is something that's recommended, but while you're entering or exiting Singapore via Changi, make sure that you do have something to eat. Some unique to Singapore options include the mock hawker stalls at Terminal 3. They sell real hawker food, but the decor is a bit recreated. Pu Tien, which is a homegrown Singaporean restaurant selling a wide array of local dishes, or Four Fingers, affordable crispy fried chicken and another homegrown Singaporean brand. Also check out Irvin's Salted Egg Yolk Fish Skin for an interesting local snack choice that you can eat on the plane. While at Changi Airport, make sure that you check out the Butterfly Garden, indoor slide, and free movie theater for more things that you can do that are unique to Singapore. Jewel is the other airport location I recommend. It's located right next to the main Changi terminals, and it's a treasure of its own unique to Singapore. It has a giant 40 meter high indoor waterfall that's surrounded by over 2,000 trees and shrubs from around the world. It also has a cool train running through the middle, though that one you need to pass through customs to get a ride on. While you're visiting Jewel, check out the Canopy Park level at the top. There's a nice free viewing area for the waterfall, or alternatively you can pay a few dollars to check out the bridge, the hedge maze, and the slide. These do cost that few dollars, but can be a great experience, particularly if you're visiting the airport in transit and with kids. I found the best time to visit Jewel is when you're leaving Singapore though. A lot of airlines have early check-in at Jewel, or you can always drop your bag at the storage service and then explore the waterfall and great food before flying off to your next destination. If you're flying on to another destination in Asia, my next unique thing to do in Singapore is actually to pick up a SIM card. Singapore sells some great prepaid SIM cards that allow you to use gigabytes of data across dozens of countries. I like Simba. Typically cost around $20 for 10 gigabytes that lasts 30 days. It's also prepaid, so you don't need to worry about going over the limit. I found this is great value if you're visiting lots of different countries around Asia, where the cost of buying a SIM card for each country really adds up. For some more fun things to do in Singapore itself though, check out Gardens by the Bay. There are over 100 hectares of park area located within the gardens, and the highlight is the iconic super trees. These are 25 to 50 meter tall tree-like structures that are home to more than 200 species of plants. Also check out the Cloud Forest and the Flower Dome while you're visiting the gardens for an unforgettable experience. If you plan your trip at the right time, check out the special events and festivals area. There are often special displays for the Mid-Autumn Festival, Christmas Wonderland, and the Singapore Garden Festival. If you're in Singapore on a nature trip, make sure you check out the Night Safari. Singapore is home to the world's first night zoo, the Night Safari located at Mandai. There are currently over 900 animals from around the globe, including elusive nocturnal species that you don't normally get to see at other zoos. The safari costs $55 to visit, and I recommend taking a taxi to get there. For even more nature, check out Singapore's UNESCO World Heritage listed botanic gardens. The gardens are over 150 years old and have been an important source of research and conservation for tropical plants native to Southeast Asia. There are over 10,000 types of plants to see, including rare and endangered species. When you visit, check out the themed areas, such as the Healing Garden that showcases various medicinal plants that people have used in the past. Best of all, the botanic gardens is free. There are a few small paid areas, but you can access the majority of the gardens for free. The way I typically recommend to explore the gardens is to start at the Botanic Gardens MRT station, then walk down through the gardens to the Napier MRT station to get home again. If you're interested in something a bit closer to town, make sure you get in a photo shoot with the merlion. The merlion is a mythical creature with the head of a lion and the body of a fish. It's said to represent Singapore's original name, Singapura, the Lion City, while symbolizing Singapore's humble beginnings as a fishing village. The merlion can be seen as the embodiment of Singapore's history, resilience, and transformation. Visiting the merlion is free. There is no charge for taking photos of or around the statue. And to get there, I usually recommend one of the following three options. So option number one is to catch the bus to Fullerton Square bus stop. It's the most direct, as you simply cross the road, walk through a building, and you're at the statue. Option number two is to take the MRT to Raffles Place Station. You can walk through the iconic Fullerton Hotel with a permanent display on the history of the building as you walk through the underpass to get to the merlion. Or option number three is that you can use Esplanade MRT Station and walk across the Jubilee Bridge. This is bathed in million views of Marina Bay Sands while giving you a great angle to get in some early shots of the Merlion before you reach the statue itself. Speaking of the MRT, Singapore also has one of the world's biggest automated train systems. It's over 230 kilometers long and links nearly all the destinations I mentioned in this video. Most trains operate completely without drivers. This means that you can see out the front and the back of the train as it travels, and it's also a really cheap way to travel around the city. Most journeys will cost you between $1 and $2, and you can use your credit card as a ticket. Singapore's train network really is an easy way to get around. If you want more information about how to take advantage of it, make sure you check out my video here.